Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. Today we're going to talk about an awesome, free and open source custom scripting language for Microsoft Windows called AutoHotkey. And use it to create some script for our folks who have keyboards that doesn't have any dedicated multimedia keys or macros and want to make some for their own use. Granted that this is a very basic tutorial, but hey, you gotta start somewhere.
Sure hope we don't blow it.
Let's go! So, what is AutoHotkey? Besides the information that I have shared earlier, AutoHotkey initially was aimed at providing easy keyboard shortcuts or hotkeys, fast macro creation, and software automation. Why use AutoHotkey? Well, AutoHotkey is free and open source. That means we can use it for free.
And that's a great price!
We can even make improvements if we want to or if we have the skill set to do so, and it's really easy to use. We can use it for games, automation scripts, and a lot more complicated stuff that we will not cover here. And of course, all the necessary links will be provided in the description down below. Alright, let's download it. Just Google it or click the link in the description. Click on download. Current version, of course. Okay. Then click on hotkeys and find the list of keys under usage and syntax. These are the keyboard keys that we will use. Specifically, insert, home, page up, page down, delete, and end. You can use your other unused keys if you want to. For example, if you don't normally use your function keys, you can use those. After that, go to your downloads folder and paste the installer wherever you want. I will paste it on my old AutoHotkey folder. As you can see here, I've been using AHK since 2015. Mainly for the mute function. And even if I can use IQ for my macros, I still have AHK, because it's easier to plot the coordinates of the mouse cursor on it. Here are some macros that I have added since I posted my peripherals upgrade video, which you can see right here. I used this for my work. Now, let's install AHK. We can either click on Express or Custom Installation, and for this one, I would go with Express. Alright, installation complete. Click on exit, then find the installation folder. Windows Spy. This was the script that I have used to plot the coordinates for my mouse click macro that I use for work. See, this script displays the coordinates of the mouse cursor in real time. And here's the mouse click script that I use. By the way, I was not the one who wrote the code for this. I just found it on some forum and edited it to fit my use case, and unfortunately, I forgot where I got the initial code. So, whoever made this, if you're watching, thank you. Your code helped me out a lot for years. Let's take a look at the code now, shall we? To do that, just right-click on it and click on Edit Script. There it is. These right here are the coordinates where the mouse cursor will go after pressing a certain key. Now, this is the keyboard key where the macro is stored or what is needed to press to activate the macro. When I press the shift key, the mouse cursor will go to these coordinates or location and perform a left mouse click. To use the script, just right-click on it and click on Compile Script. It will make another script which we can use to activate or deactivate the macro. Okay, double-click to activate. Now pay attention to the location of the mouse cursor. See, when I press the shift key, wherever the mouse cursor is, it will go to the coordinates that we have set up earlier and perform a left mouse click. So now, let's create our media keys macro. To do that, let's open up the mouse click script and edit it. But first, let's go back to the list of keys. Here are the keys that we will use. Just copy the key names onto the notepad. Insert, home, page up, page down, delete, and end. Don't forget to add two colons on it to separate it from our function. Now for the function keys, let's go down to the multimedia keys. There it is. Volume mute, play, pause, volume up, down, previous, and next. After that, click on file, save as, let's name it mediakeys.ahk. The .ahk file format is important for it to be saved as an AutoHotkey script. After that, Just like before, click on Compile Script, then activate it by double-clicking. See, there it is. Now let's see if it works. If you look on the lower right part of the screen, the mute function, which was set to be activated when the insert key is pressed, is already in effect. So that's for our mute button, volume down, volume up. Now I'm going to launch iTunes because it's my main music player. Then let's try media play pause function. Again, as you can clearly see, whenever I press the home key, the music plays and pauses. It doesn't clash with the dedicated media keys as well. Volume down, play, next, 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 previous, previous, previous. Alright, so, we know that it's working just fine on iTunes while iTunes is active. Now, let's try it when iTunes is minimized. Still working. Then, let's try the media keys while in-game.
See?
Still working.
Nothing personal,
outside.
Kid. But I must go all out. Just this once.
There you go. It's still working even while playing a game just like your normal dedicated media keys. Okay, let's try it on VLC.
Alright, let's load up a lot.
Cassandra! You-
Next.
Better stay hidden. Marcos would like it.
Blood on sacred soil!
Still working just fine as well. Can't control the volume of VLC itself though. So yeah. The fact that a noob like me was able to create a simple media key script the way that I wanted to really tells you about how easy it is to use AHK. It's a wonderful software with tons of capabilities. And as always, thanks for watching and see you again next week. Maybe.